Blepharitis is the inflammation of the eyelids and eyelid margins, and it's actually really common to see it in the clinic. In fact, if you have itchy, red, dry eyes, there's a good chance that you actually have blepharitis right now. So in this video, we're gonna go over exactly what blepharitis is and also the best treatments for it, because some of the treatments may only scratch the surface. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guy. I'm a doctor eye guy with a channel that keeps your eyes healthy and your vision clear. And this video is a part one introduction video in a series of videos about blepharitis. It's so common that you might be diagnosed with blepharitis right now or know somebody that has it. So this series of videos is designed to help you manage your blepharitis with your doctor. So make sure you check out the top link in the description below to that series of videos so it can help you out. Now, blepharitis is broken down into two different categories, anterior blepharitis and posterior blepharitis. So let's head over and go over anterior blepharitis first. Anterior blepharitis is in the name. It's more anterior, or the front part of the eyelid margin at the base of the eyelashes. And just like this eyelid model here, you might get a buildup on the base of the eyelids and eyelashes, and it could look like little flakes or dandruff, kind of like getting dandruff from your hair. Sometimes people use the analogy that it looks like sugar-coated churros, the base of the eyelashes. That's kind of a gross analogy, but it kind of does look like that. Now, this buildup is usually a combination of your own dead skin cells and bacteria, your natural flora bacteria that's in there. And some people just have more dead skin cells, and so they might be more prone to getting anterior blepharitis. And all of this can cause your eyelids to get red. It can cause lid inflammation, almost make it have a crusty, scaly appearance, and can also cause your eyes to get dry, your own eyeballs to get red and inflamed as well. Now, with the name posterior blepharitis, it's more posterior, or on the back eyelid margin of the eyelids. And this usually involves the meibomian glands in the eyelids. Now, we have about 25 to 30 oil glands called meibomian glands in each one of our eyelids. Now, the words posterior blepharitis and meibomian gland dysfunction are sometimes used interchangeably because there's a lot of overlap in those two conditions. Now, usually when you have posterior blepharitis, you likely have meibomian gland dysfunction as well. Now, if the meibomian oil glands are inflamed, they have a harder time secreting oil every time you blink. And that oil is very, very, very important at helping you have a healthy tear film. If the oil's not there, then your tears will evaporate really fast and cause dry eyes, redness, inflammation on the eyes. And so now you can kind of see how everything's linked and overlapped. Now, a lot of times posterior blepharitis can be associated with rosacea as well. With these excess skin cells, bacteria will sometimes create a matrix on the surface of your eyelids called a biofilm. And in this biofilm, it can involve one or many types of bacteria. And this biofilm is actually a perfect environment to actually reproduce more bacteria. So it's almost like creating a colony or a city or a village right on the surface of your eyelids, and can be really tricky to get rid of because it's pretty much on there, attached onto the surface of the eyelids in this biofilm. Now, here's a little video that I took of my own eyelids and eyelashes. I also suffer from blepharitis. I actually purposely didn't clean my eyelids and lashes last night so you could actually see this film. But on here, you can actually see a mild amount of that biofilm, kind of that scaly, shiny look to it. Sometimes it's actually kind of gross to actually look at a really close-up video or a picture of your own eyelids or eyelashes. But I just wanted to at least give you an example, my own example. And that biofilm is exactly what can actually clog or block your meibomian oil glands. It can sometimes contribute to the oil glands getting a little bit harder and coming out a little bit thick, and also can contribute to anterior blepharitis with more bacteria and more skin cells just building on top of that biofilm. And this is the challenge with blepharitis treatment. Sometimes certain treatments can't get rid of that biofilm adequately or enough. And so sometimes there's a little bit more or better treatments out there. So let's go over treatments. Now, remember, I have a playlist of videos going over specific treatments for blepharitis, but I do think there are a few things I want to mention in this video. You can break the treatments down into classic treatments that have been around for years, and now more advanced treatments that target blepharitis specifically. In the past, a classic treatment might be baby shampoo. When we'd wash our face, we wouldn't wash our eyelids and eyelashes because we didn't want to burn our eyes with the soap. And so doctors would recommend the non-burn baby shampoo. But what they found is the preservatives in the baby shampoo sometimes could do more harm than good. So yeah, we're gonna move on from baby shampoo. Other classic treatments that you actually might be doing right now would be warm compresses to loosen those oils, make those oils more liquid. Also eyelid scrubs. Eyelid scrubs have been around for a while to try and clean the eyelids, clean the dandruff and debris off the eyelashes. Also, sometimes if it got bad enough, a doctor would prescribe an antibiotic or an antibiotic ointment or maybe a steroid ointment to reduce the inflammation and kill the infection to destroy all the excess bacteria on the eyelids. Now, the classic treatments, warm compresses, eyelid scrubs are still good, but may only be scratching the surface with your blepharitis. So now let's move on to the more advanced or the more specific treatments for blepharitis that might do a better job at clearing out that biofilm that's sitting on your eyelids, clearing off the debris, cleaning out the excess bacteria, and really helping with your blepharitis. Now, if you really want to get good results, you really need to be cleaning your eyelids and eyelashes every night. You definitely still want to do eyelid scrubs from the classic treatment. It's still going to clean your eyelids and eyelashes, but if you want to step up your eyelid scrub game, you can check out these eyelid scrubs that have been made more specifically for blepharitis. They might have other ingredients in there like green tea extract, tea tree oil. Tea tree oil can help with mites that might live on your eyelashes, Demodex. And so there are other ingredients in there that might help clean your eyelashes better, also help control the bacteria and actually moisturize your eyelids. So definitely check those out. Remember, I have a link in the description of the series of videos. I did a video about my favorite eyelid scrubs, and I'll put links to those different eyelid scrubs if you want to check those out. You can also check out eyelid cleaning foams that are also really good. They might be a little bit more gentle on the eyelids if you don't want to use the eyelid scrub pads. Another one that I've mentioned in another video is to use something called hypochlorous acid solution, which may sound scary, but it's actually really safe. In fact, you can spray this right onto your eyelids and eyelashes. In fact, if you spray it every night, you can let it air or maybe pat dry with a cotton wipe and actually just leave it on there. Now, this is designed to control or help manage the overgrowth of bacteria on your eyelids and eyelashes. This will help blepharitis from getting out of control. Now, hypochlorous acid solution is over the counter, so you don't need a prescription. And I'll put links in the description below to my favorite ones, but I actually use this one quite a bit and I like it. Okay, now let's step up our treatment a little bit. Like I said, it can be challenging to get rid of that biofilm that sits and cakes on the surface of the eyelids. So we're gonna step it up a little bit and here are my recommendations for that. The first product that I'd recommend is actually a more natural treatment if you want to go that route. It's an eye drop or an ointment, and it's called Manuka Honey. And I actually did a specific video about my experience with Manuka Honey and how it might help soothe your eyes and help control the overgrowth of bacteria on your eyelids. So definitely check out that video if you want to go that route. The second product I'd recommend is actually a cleaning system called Myboclean. It comes with a 4-pack a year supply of these silicone medical grade scrubbers with these little soft little bristles that help kind of clean your eyelids. It has a nice shape to it so you can get into the corners there and actually works really well. And it comes with probably one of the best eyelid cleansers that I've ever used made with organic ingredients, including Manuka honey, coconut oil, aloe vera, sea salt, and you actually put it right onto the scrubber and then you can actually start scrubbing your eyelids and eyelashes. Now this can agitate and get off that biofilm at least a little bit better off the eyelashes and the eyelid margins so you can actually get in there. So this has definitely helped me. So definitely check into this. Again, I'll put the links in the description. Now you can get the MyboClean system for about $86. Again, it's a year supply. Definitely worth it. The next product that I recommend, the eyelid device called Nulids, and it can run between $200 and $300, but it's really nice because it actually has an oscillating silicone tip on there. So when you're actually cleaning your eyelids, when you turn it on, you clean your eyelids, it's actually scrubbing and turning and oscillating so it can agitate and hopefully get off that biofilm even a little bit better. But that is something that I would definitely look into if some of these other treatments aren't really cutting it. Now, even with those great over-the-counter treatment options, sometimes it's still a challenge to get rid of that biofilm, and so you may require an in-office procedure called microbleph exfoliation. Now we actually offer this to our patients. This is called blephex, similar to nulids where it has an oscillating tip. It has a sponge on the top that you actually soak in an eyelid cleanser, and this actually spins at about 2,000 revolutions per minute. Now this will really agitate and does a great job at clearing and cleaning off that biofilm plaque that's on the eyelids. Now your doctor might go over each eyelid maybe multiple times, might take 5 minutes per eye, but this does a really great job at breaking the cycle, actually clearing off that biofilm plaque on your eyelids. And so you might need this if the other treatments don't work. You might need it again in the future just to break the cycle again and again. So remember, this is an option and you might want to check with your eye doctor to see if it's offered in their office. Now, if you learned something new from this video, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe for my future videos, and make sure you check out that playlist to learn more specifics about blepharitis. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy. Stay focused.